Friday, scammer alert. This one's called Kevin Kelvin Smarts. It's a different sort of one. I don't know if any of you have had this one before. Anyway, he says, Would you like if I give you more hints? I would love to work with the FBI too. I said, okay, this is on one of my scammer pages. He said, thank you for your response. I appreciate the opportunity to remain anonymous for the time being. I've been conducting research on this topic for several years and have gathered evidence to support my findings. Out of the concern of my safety and privacy, I would like to request that my comment be removed. I'm a responsible citizen of my country and am motivated by the hope of making the world a better place. I hope you will honour my request to maintain the confidentiality of my information. I said, yep. He said, that's great. So how do you suggest I provide you with the various hints to get to work with the FBI, as I initially stated? I said, it's you that's offering you. You tell me. I haven't a clue what you're saying. It's gone straight out of my head. He said, okay. I said, tell me. He said, I have proper information related to your contents that will prove very much of its right and will provide reasonable proof of how they are being conducted in detail due to the research done in a couple of years. I said, okay, that's good. Tell me then. He said, so do you prefer I contact the FBI either directly or through you, as I am not a US citizen, or I supply the information so you can use it for your content vividly? I said, oh God, just tell me. He said, I'm glad you're open to receiving this information from me. However, I would prefer to use a more secure method of communication to ensure that our data is protected. Do you have any suggestions for end-to-end encrypted messaging services that we could use? This way we can be sure that our conversation is private and secure. WhatsApp? Telegram? Signal, maybe? I said, TikTok is private and secure. He said, I don't think so. It is, but if you say so, I will definitely share it. I hope I don't get banned. I said, you won't. He said, and then there was like 2 days, and he said, hello, I apologise for the delay in getting back to you. The information I have on exposing how scammers work is compiled in a PDF file, and I think you'll find it interesting. I'm curious to know how you might use this information. Would you mind letting me know what you plan to do with the information I'm sharing? I said, I'll just read it and absorb it. He said, that's great. I'm going to look for it and share it while I'm back from work. But don't you think it's better if we share it with the Internet Crime Complaint Centre, IC3? I'm hoping there might be rewards attached. I said, okay. He said, what do you think? Are you interested in working with me? I said, no. He said, so I was hoping if you could get me to the right authorities. Is that okay with you? I said, how? He said, I'm suggesting you have an idea. I have spent so much working on this and I feel it would be wrong if I let it go for free. How about I get commission for each article? I submit. I believe it might be the way for appreciating my efforts. What do you think? Oh, I said, okay. He said, you're supposed to strike a deal and I'll follow. What does it seem you're unenthusiastic about my offer? Just let me know if you're interested and I promise that I'll provide all the information I've gathered concerning this. I said, you know what, I don't really understand. He said, and I said, all right, I'm interested, what now? He said, what reward will I be getting from you if I start coming with information about what you're looking for? I said, oh, I get it, you're after money. He said, laugh out loud, not after money here, I'm talking about rewards. They called it different things. He said, I'm serious about bringing the information to light because I've worked so hard to make it a success. I've spent close on $100 on developing this information. It's not a lot, is it? And I'm not willing to simply give it away for free. I have put in both time and money, and I believe my effort has created value that deserves to be recognised. I'm committed to making this idea a success, and I'm willing to put it in work to turn it into a profitable venture. I'm assured you'll profit from it too. Do you think that's a bad idea? Does anyone else not know what he's talking about? I said, no, but I'm not sure what you want me to do. He said, I truly believe that the effort and resources I dedicated to this article was significant and provided value. Acknowledging this with a reimbursement of $50 would be greatly appreciated, and I would help offset a portion of the cost I incurred during the production process. I recognise that my reach is limited and believe that partnering with you can create a win-win situation Allow me to provide your audience with informative content while simultaneously showcasing your expertise to those who may doubt your abilities, therefore providing value to both parties and discrediting the unfounded criticisms against you. I said, situate, you're asking me for money. He said, if I present you with a pitch that includes information, will you consider reimbursing me $50 out of the $100 I spent? I said, how can you spend money on information? It doesn't make sense. He said, if you understand me clearly, I made it clear to you that I carry out research and various investigation concerning this information I'm about to share with you, and it did cost a lot putting it together, so I can present it with ease for your understanding. Was it on paper? I don't know. I didn't know you were British. I thought you were American, he said. I said, no, I'm British. I said, what were the costs involved then? The total cost of the project amounts to $100. I said, but you're not telling me the itemised cost for me to understand. He said, I don't have a detailed breakdown of expenses, but I can confidently say that I have dedicated considerable time and resources to this project. Despite already working 5 to 6 hours a day, I still set aside 2 hours a day to contribute. The amount of time and effort I've invested over a period of 5 months has been substantial, and I believe it warrants compensation of at least $50 to recognise my contributions to this project. I said, okay. So the money is for the time spent. What do I get? He said, I'm offering to relinquish all my work on this project for you to use and share with your audience. This includes any information, research and materials I've created, which I believe will be of value to your viewers. It's been 24 hours and I've not gotten any response from you. I said, I do have a life, you know. I'm not on here all the time. He said, oh, apologies for the oversight. Of course, you have a busy life beyond our chats. I'm eager to hear your thoughts and insights on the topic we discussed earlier, as your opinion is invaluable in determining the best path forward for us to go. I said, I really don't have a clue what you're on about. How do we make money from it? He said, I'm suggesting you make a deal with me. I give you all the detailed information I have investigated on how scam is being carried out and how to avoid it. Then you'll reward me with a token of $50. I guess that's too small for the offer, but I'll accept it. It's essential to correct and improve the quality of information shared about scams on your TikTok platform. While your efforts to raise awareness about scams are commendable, it has come to my attention that some of the information you've shared has been inaccurate and incomplete, leading to misinformation and possible vulnerability among your followers. Misinformation about scams can be just as dangerous as the scams themselves, as it may lead people to adopt incorrectly safety measures or ignore real threats. I'm suggesting you make a deal with me. I give you all the detailed information I have investigated on how scam is being carried out and how to avoid it. Then you reward me with a token of $50. I guess that's too small for the offer, but I'll accept it. Didn't he just say that? If you're agreeable to this proposal, I would be delighted to work with you to help reduce the crime rate and protect the public from scams. I said, you're still not telling me what it's about, really, are you? Oh, what's happened to the phone? I've fallen asleep. I already told you, he said, I've got detailed information about how recent scams are being carried out nowadays in written form. Do you understand? I said, I don't really care. I can read about it on Google. He said, what do you mean? You get all this from Google? I said, yeah, all the scammer formats are on there to read. I have them. It's under Yahoo Boys, all there to copy and paste. All right then, he said, before I go, I just want you to know that what you just said is part of the deception they've adopted. It's easy to be tricked by these scammers because they're very cunning and know how to cover their tracks. Even the information available on Google is false, and it's being used to deceive vulnerable people who are looking for ways to protect themselves because they are very smart and would never expose their methods for operations to the public. Fortunately, I was able to learn about their operation during my time in the country, where we all believe these activities are majorly carried out, and I got this information from someone who has about to sentence for his crimes. Consider this advice a piece of my work's proposition for you to get corrected on time. The reason I'm doing this is because I appreciate your work and I want the world to know and to be a better place as you do. I said, oh yeah, right. And you want money from me, then you will block me. My friends have had the same messages from you. He said, I hear you. I can finally see where you're coming from. I'm sorry about that and there's totally no way I've convinced you after being scammed. But I already present you with the pitch, prove I'm different. I said, I haven't been scammed and I'm not that stupid. He said, oh, now I understand. It was your friends, not you. You were directly affected by these scams. I said, oh, my God. I said, I tell you what, why don't you try and sell it to someone else? Because I got bored. And with that, poof, he was gone. Catch you later.